What's up, guys? My name is Justin. Welcome back to the channel. Today we are back on NASCAR Dirt to Daytona, ready for another episode of Mod Racing. This should be a New Hampshire race. Yes, it will, but I forget where we go after that. I should know by now. I've played this game enough. Welch Valley, okay. And then New Hampshire, right? And then Martinsville. Okay, so I'm stupid. There are only four races left. I don't know what I'm talking about. So two New Hampshires, a Welch Valley, and a Martinsville. I expect to be pretty strong at Welch Valley again, and I expect to be pretty strong at Martinsville, as long as we survive. I'm not sure if that's going to be a thing for sure, but it's a good enough track for me on this game at least. So whether that works out, I don't know. We'll have to wait and see. In the meantime, we're going to head to New Hampshire, and then we'll have Welch, I guess. So I'm excited for Welch. Let's make sure again that we have our gearing set up somewhere that's survivable. It's the biggest deal in the world, but it's kind of important to have gearing that doesn't want to kill you and explode every single time. And obviously we just gotta set it once, which is good. So. Alright, here we go. Out on the track. That's the good thing. So far we're okay. We're just gonna do one set of corners, make sure we maximize our straightaway speed. And then we know where we stand. This is gonna be a struggle for straightaway speed, this track. I already know that. I'm accepting that. So we'll take all the spoiler out of it, try to help as much as we can. As usual, we'll go down, you know, two clicks of gear, I guess technically up two clicks of gear, and then we'll let her rip. So give me all the spoiler angle back. We don't need handling, we need straightaway speed. We have great handling with our what we got already. Oh, we gotta scroll down. Alright, 382 it is. I guess that's good enough. I don't know if that's a big swing or not. Don't know what to expect for Q lap speed. Obviously if we struggle here, we'll probably struggle again in the second race here, next episode out, if we could run like 30, 50, I think that would be really good for me. So I keep thinking of used to go in and think of the air button. Alright. 30, 50 would be good enough for me. That should put us around top 5, so I think that would be a successful Q lap. All things considered, I think that would give us a shot for a top 5 in the race, much like the original last time about outcomes, because we have to. Last episode, if you didn't watch it, go watch it. It's a good one. Hopefully today's a little better. I'm excited for Welch in the next race. That's going to be a track that I definitely have a shot at. Hopefully all things go right. Maybe another surprise victory. We'll see. One lap to go. Obviously one lap in Q here. I don't know if 30-50 is realistic. We are really going to struggle down these long straightaways. We're just going to be absolutely blitzed by everybody who will be older in this race. William Anderson is the points leader. So it's pretty tight still at the top. So we'll have to see where those two guys are in the starting order when we get from here. Is 30-50 realistic? Let's see what we got here.
Alright, let's see where we play.
Okay, so that's not awful. That's going to probably put us around 5th or 6th, which is good enough for me. That's a solid lap as far as I'm concerned. William Anderson is ahead of us. Not ideal. Where is John Bunny? Oh, he's back in 11th, so he was like 1.7 seconds off of me. Said. Alright, well, William Anderson right in front of us. We'll try not to run him over here immediately.
There's a green flag.
Crazy and direct. not great, to say the least. It's not great. So. Seven On the outside here. Especially the best we've rolled there, still can't quite get up the corner. That was the best we've rolled through there. We have 4.5 laps to try and mix up the pound and mix up the stick. Slap right there. I think that was a pretty solid one. Carrying the corners from that both ends. It's not our best one. It's 3/10 off. So what the hell did I do on our best slap right now? I'm confused. There's Danny Seaman up ahead. I recognize that green and orange any day. Yeah, we still can get right to him. There's no way, even if we can get next to him, we're going to be in a drag race back to the line. So we're going to need traffic interference and obviously just to protect. That was not what I was trying to do. Cloud over the guy. What's up, Danny Seaman? There you go. Yeah, there you go. So, kind of let him get away there. Hurt the nose a little bit, but now he's going to certainly be unassailable at this point. So, we can't build up enough to quite get back to him. Unless that green car up ahead really provides a traffic roadblock, then I think we're going to settle up for 6th. First non top 5 since the DNF still be here at Dennis Lynch. It couldn't have gone on forever. We still might have a shot. And I'm glad that we have kind of good 6-place speed. That's encouraging. That track that I thought we may struggle at, we struggled more than this even. So,
2 to go.
We'll see how it plays out. 2 laps, we got to send it here. Leader's got way up the road. They should be getting the white flag in a second now. Here's we're off turn 2. There it is. Final lap. Probably going to be Blake Anderson increasing his points lead, I guess, but even if he's not, he's in front of us. So, is behind us, and we can probably take away that spot in points. We may lose another one depending on who's where exactly. But last lap, we're not going to be able to get Grace across.
Last lap.
Last lap, first time. So, just don't quite have what we need. It's close, but it's not quite what we need. We can use a little bit more motor. But, sometimes that's how the thing comes, I guess. Need a good run, need a nice bounce back for the Belgium, that's what we should be on top 5 there pretty easily. Anything better than that would be a big bonus. So that's that.
Well, finished in the top half.
Jeff Anders did put Blake Anderson back in third, so that might keep us in just barely in touch. I can English again. I was going to say intact, but we were already intact. Most laps led, though, for William Anderson. It's going to give him a couple more bonus points. We'll probably still only be about 40 behind or so, I would assume. 30 to 40. Give me like 8 grand. 8,800 for not getting our top 5 bonus. We'll take that. That's a big deal. All right. We're up to 2nd in points, as I kind of predicted. We're 38 back, so again, right on the mark. Dude still can't win. Jeff Ondich wins that one, who was, you know, like 28th in points before that race. That's interesting. Yeah, Danny Seaman, 16 points up. Yeah, so we only have 17 points now over John Bundy, so he's still in. Francis Lee, only another 4 back. So the top 4 really still in contention with 3 races. 114 is a steep hill for Hemeseth to climb. Still lead the way with 6 top 5s. That's our first non-top 5 since race 1. Like I said, we still got the 3 races left, so 30 grand, though. We're halfway to our 60 number. If we can make about 10, 12 grand here, I would feel really good about where we're at, even at New Hampshire, then with that 10,000 bonus, being able to get the big engine for next season, that would be encouraging, I think. All right. Question is, how do we perform here at Welch? That is going to be the $368 million question. We are not running 115. We might run 119 dead. It would put us like second-ish. What was our best year last time? 18.9, so that's right where second place is right now, so for this second, third, fourth ish, we could run 19 dead. I think that would be a fair enough lap. Francis Lee, John Bundy still in the points chase with us. We'll have to keep an eye out for that in the queue and in the race. Global cloud, they're not ideal. The rubber strips on exit, big high curves, at least in that corner. Darn competitive in Super Mario last time out. Hopefully we can have similar competitiveness this time. That would be a success in my mind. I love this track. This is one of the better tracks in this game. I think it's a fictional track. I'm certain it's a fictional track. obviously one of my stronger tracks being the road race. So. There we go. Alright, single qualifying lap coming up. We'll see what we got for the best. I'd like to think that the road is going to be reach, really. Be relatively solid. Should have been about high 18 at least. A nice lap together. If I make a mistake, obviously I'd change things. That would be dope. Right? 15 flat? Where did that come from? Oh, William Anderson back in 14th place. I know John Bundy's right up behind us at 15.3. But William Anderson back a full 14 and a half seconds off somehow. Imagine running 37.7 around here, Luis. Imagine being 23 seconds off pace. That's crazy. Anyways, we're going to fight John Bundy for this one, and that's going to be, I guess, kind of the battle for gets to take the championship lead, assuming William Anderson finishes outside the top 10. Alright, well, this is a 9-lap race, I think that'll be
set. The race is going green. Alright,
this is us versus John Bundy. Here we go. Boy, would this be a big one to have. I did not expect that lap. That was for this. For the lap is not getting pulled out. We'll see what kind of speed he has.
last lap.
The outside of turn one. All is well. Last lap. Jumping on these birds, but still getting the expectation for sure. I still think Anderson will be out again. Which would turn one now. It's just a nice 60% which isn't as much as a great group thinks. This has been a thing, folks. It's going to be victory number two if I don't botch it right to the end. This is the track I thought we might get the first one at, but some cheating McDouchebag, Phoenix style lines. Able to first one at one out with that place. This is going to be the one that I have circled, though, always. 30 seconds back to fit. That's quite the spread. Final corner, it's going to be victory for Rodos. It's such a quiz, two-time modified winner.
Great job!
And, once again, I believe, I didn't look at the whole thing, but that's fine. Alright, how many points did William Anderson get? We were behind, what, like, 38 or something like that? William Anderson won 21, so he only lost 69, so we're only 31 points ahead of him, too, so... If we have a rough time at New Hampshire next time out, he could still be right back in ahead in the Martinsville, along with everybody else. So this should be like 20 grand here because of that victory. 26! Oh shit! Alright, well. That's the thing. We'll like see it. Alright, we are the points leader. 31 points, 37 over John Fundy. Francis Lee starting to fall back. He's 96 back. He's going to have a hard time from there. First two-time winner of the season. We like to see it. Yeah, thanks for nothing. Alright, how much money do we have? 56,000. Alright. Alright, well, next time out is going to be the finale of Season 1. It's going to be New Hampshire and Martinsville. Could this be the day a rookie wins, whatever this thing is? Oh, I'm excited. Alright, that's going to be all. Make sure you drop a like and a sub down below. Don't want you to miss any of the action from NASCAR Dirt to Daytona, Need for Speed, Hot Pursuit to iRacing or anything else I may post. So. As always, I hope you enjoyed as much as I did. I'm excited again. I was excited for that last dirt season. I'm excited that maybe we can close this thing out. But even if we don't, we'll be able to stack up some money and go at it next season for sure. Because we're going to getting another 10 grand. We will be getting that motor. We'll have to make a decision if we want to do after New Hampshire if all goes well. We'll deal with that when we get there. That's going to be all for today. Until next time.